Bir gece 401 sanımında Alp'le birlikteyiz. İntikam amacı olacağını söylemiştim. Şu an kendisinin nasıl bir sunum yaptığını herkese göstereceğim. Hangi sınıfı çekiyorum?
Ne daha bellik ya, ceketini giymiyor adam.
Hello everyone. Today I'm going to present my proposal, which is about alternative ways for preventing water consumption on iPhones. My name is Alp. Thank you for coming my presentation. My presentation will be consist of six parts again: introduction, problem definition, proposed solutions, criteria for selecting the solutions, proposed solutions, research methodology, and bibliography. The reason why I choose this topic is that I'm an iPhone user and I use my phone very much. I'm using too much apps on my phone, for example, Facebook, Twitter, or other kind of applications. But one day I realized that the 10 years before I have got a Nokia cell phone, which can be survived at least 10 days without recharging again. However, my iPhone today, I'm using this iPhone at last my 3 years, I have to recharge it every day. So it makes my phone useless in some way, that not only me, of course. Today's technology, mobile technology, and daily usage of iPhones are getting increased every day, and people use these phones for business and personal interest. So, of course, all of this needs some energy. However, lots of apps and hardware like this technology requires more energy, so it results as low power and insufficient energy. I believe that this causes prevents the technological improvements and user dissatisfaction because of this issue. So when I investigate these causes, I have two root causes for this problem. The first root cause is that the battery life of the iPhone. It depends on the battery technology, of course. In this phone, it uses lithium-ion battery, which is today's best technological battery, which seems the best technological battery type of the phone for phone. And the second root cause is applications and hardware. As the developers provide more sophisticated and complex applications, of course the iPhone needs more energy for runs and executes that hardware. So the true root cause of the problem is identified as battery life and energy consumed for applications and hardware. When I examined the first root cause, the decreasing battery capacity, the recharging of lithium batteries has got some side effects, such as, for example, when I first buy this phone, it can survive at least 1 week without recharging. However, as long as I use that phone and I recharge it at 1 week, it's going to decrease that lifespan. So today I have to recharge that phone every day. which is the side effect of the recharging lithium batteries. As you recharge it, the lifespan of the batteries decreases. The second root cause is applications and hardware. As you can see, I investigate the iPhone types, which is 3GS, 4 and 4S. The version of that phones are increasing in right to left order. As you can see, the iPhone version is increased, but the standby time is decreased or constant, stay constant. That's because of the as the technological applications and hardware are increased, it needs more energy to consume. So it's it decreases the battery life of the phone. However, 10 years ago, for example, Nokia has got up to 400 hours standby time, which is greater than all of the iPhone types, even if it is 10 years before.